have strong families and a president who's willing to go out and talk about it. You know, there's three things that people can do if they want to stay out of poverty in America. Number one, work, obviously, but the two that we don't talk about, graduate from high school and get married before you have children. We have a president of the United States who actually tells recipients of federal funds they can't talk about marriage if they're in a program counseling teenagers about how to not have children out of wedlock. They can't talk about marriage. They're not allowed to under the federal law because it's only one of a variety of different lifestyles, and we can't promote it over others, even though we know it can keep people out of poverty and to enrich our society. We need a president who shares our values. We need a president who can stand up and unite America around a common set of values. Hopefully the people of Iowa, after all those meetings, have seen that I'm sincere about all of this, and I've got a track record to back it up. And I hope tonight, as you make this tough decision, I know it will be, that you'd give us an opportunity in Iowa to speak, be bold, lead, put who's out there that will really make the changes that are necessary throughout our country, from the family to the economy to our national security, and I hope you choose me. Thank you, and God bless you.
Former Pennsylvania Senator Rick Santorum making his closing argument tonight to the voters of Polk County, Iowa. He's in Johnston, just outside Des Moines, one of the larger caucus sites there. Of the more than 1,700 caucus sites in Iowa, they range from just a few people to big crowded rooms like the one you saw Rick Santorum addressing there. The candidate not exactly giving a barn burner of a closing speech, but clearly speaking from the heart and hitting his core issues, which are and pretty much have always been family values. Regardless of which candidate wins the Republican nomination, the Obama campaign will reportedly attempt to tie that candidate to specifically the Tea Party and to the unpopularity of the current Congress. NBC's Luke Russert is in Washington with more on that strategic aspect of 2012 politics. Hey, Luke.
Hey, Rachel. How are you doing?
Good.
Well, it's interesting, Rachel. We're going to see, I think, which is the biggest untold story coming out of Iowa tonight, is whoever the winner is, as they move forward, is really going to have to deal with the legislation that was passed out of the House Republican Congress over this last year and the future legislation they will pass in 2012. Now, nobody talks about this because it's not the horse race, it's actually the real legislative policies. But the House GOP passed some very Republican things, or very conservative things, that some Democrats have even labeled as extremist. Things like the Ryan budget. The Ryan budget, which passed 235 to 189, that got no Democratic votes, only four Republican voted against it, in essence, to some degree, privatizes Medicare, would cut funding to Head Start, would deregulate a lot of the EPA. There was even a lot of abortion bills that were voted through the House GOP that would have, in one instance, allowed a hospital, if they had religious moral feelings, to not perform an abortion on a woman who is near death. So there's a lot of these bills that passed through the House that a lot of Democrats feel are going to be thrown around the neck of the nominee, whoever comes out tonight, and in the whole process. And it's the untold story right now, and it's very interesting because as the House GOP has gone to the right and gotten more conservative, and as these folks try to run in a general direction, it's going to be asked at the campaign stops, would you support the Ryan budget all out? Mitt Romney's doubled down on that. As the scrutiny gets more and more, it's going to be interesting to see how much this legislation passed out of the House really affects these candidates. One last thing, Mitt Romney has been very much supportive of a balanced budget amendment, Rachel. That's something that economists from both sides say would be just absolutely horrific to the economy because it doesn't allow for that of a recession to show. That's something that was voted down in the House. That's going to get a lot of play. So while we talk about the horse race in Iowa and the states further, look at the actual legislative achievements that happened through the House GOP Congress over the last year that were going to happen over 2012. That's an awful lot of fodder for the Democratic campaign operation, Rachel.
NBC's Luke Russert in Washington. Luke, thanks. We will be checking back in with you. I appreciate it. Looking at the closing argument there from Rick Santorum, hearing what the Democratic strategy is going to be, you do have to wonder how successful the Democrats are going to be at trying to make the primary running to the right tactics that you were talking about, Al, hang around the necks of the candidate in the general election.
Well, I think Luke just raised some of the ways it can happen. When you look at the fact that you look at Ryan's bill and all of the things that it takes away, Then you talk about you need jobs. Well, you cannot argue, let's give us the pipeline, the Keystone Pipeline, to provide jobs, which are really about 6,500 jobs. All the president and Democrats have to say, well, if we just upgraded some of the power plants, if we dealt with retrofixing residential and commercial space, we create more jobs. So when you get past the rhetoric and deal with job creation, what the entitlements really mean to grandma, I think they lose. And Rick Santorum cannot run family against the Obama family. He loses that one.
All right, coming up, the doors will close at the caucus sites across Iowa. The voting will begin, and we will have our first characterization of the race in Iowa tonight. That is right after this. You're watching MSNBC's coverage of the Iowa caucuses.
Cranberry juice, wake up!
Best good morning, veggie style.
For half the calories plus veggie nutrition, could have had a V8.
When BP made a commitment to the Gulf, we knew it would take time, but we were determined to see it through. Today, while our work continues, I want to update you on the progress. BP has set aside $20 billion to fund economic and environmental recovery. We're paying for all spill-related cleanup costs, and we've established a $500 million fund so independent scientists can study the Gulf's wildlife and environment for 10 years. Thousands of environmental samples from across the Gulf have been analyzed by independent labs under the direction of the U.S. Coast Guard. I'm glad to report all beaches and waters are open for everyone to enjoy. And the economy is showing progress, with many areas on the Gulf Coast having their best tourism seasons in years. I was born here. I'm still here, and so is BP. We're committed to the Gulf. For everyone who loves it and everyone who calls it home.
Vicks NyQuil Cold and Flu. The nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, fever, best sleep you ever got with a cold medicine.
Atlantis. Now enjoy your fourth night free. Plus, receive up to a $400 airfare credit. Discover Atlantis and discover what's lost. Hurry, this offer ends soon.
We went from my mom's kitchen to an 8,000 square foot facility.
I'm Anthony Flynn, and I'm the owner of U-Bar.
Millions of business owners like Anthony Flynn use Vistaprint.com to promote their business, with everything from business cards to brochures to banners.
I felt like they went around to every small business and said, how can we make this as easy as possible? And they listened.
And my sister was like, this card is amazing. You actually look like a professional company now.
Get 250 premium business cards for only $10 at Vistaprint.com.
Hi, I'm Henry Winkler. And I'm here to tell homeowners that are 62 and older about a great way to live a better retirement. It's called a reverse mortgage.
Call right now to receive your free DVD and booklet with no obligation. It answers questions like how a reverse mortgage works, how much you qualify for, the ways to receive your money, and more. Plus, when you call now, you'll get this magnifier with LED light absolutely free.
When you call the experts at One Reverse Mortgage today, you'll learn the benefits of a government-insured reverse mortgage. It will eliminate your monthly mortgage payments and give you tax-free cash from the equity in your home. And here's the best part. You still own your home. Take control of your retirement today.
Call 800-935-5199 to get your free DVD, plus get a free magnifier with LED light when you call now.
It is now 8 p.m. on the East Coast. It is 7 p.m. in Iowa. And at this hour, the results of the Iowa caucuses are too early to call. But based on early entrance polling, Ron Paul Mitt Romney and Rick Santorum are competing to win in Iowa tonight. Chris Matthews is at the Polk County Convention Center in Des Moines, Iowa. He joins us now. Chris, how quickly do you expect the caucuses to move from this point? At this point, too early to call, but those three bunched at the top.
I'm hearing it's going to take a while tonight, Rachel, and I think that's a statement in itself. You know, too early to call can be misinterpreted, I know, to meaning it's going to be a close race, but I'm taking it that way because Romney is not racing above this pack or out front of this pack. The fact that he's being challenged by someone so limited in their political appeal as Rick Santorum, who was defeated in Pennsylvania by 17% for re-election. The fact that Ron Paul is able to challenge him in a serious race for president with all his baggage tells you that the Republicans are not lining up behind Mitt Romney yet. Now, maybe late tonight I'll change that view, but I've watched this thing and watched this polling now for weeks now. And what you see is a Romney problem. Although he's defeated his main opponent tonight, as we see Newt Gingrich is not in this top three, he hasn't sold himself. Now, he can keep trying to convince the right that he's a part of the right, but of course that would be dishonest because he isn't part of the political right. He's a pragmatic business guy who would like to see taxes probably lower than Barack Obama would, perhaps believes in less government than Barack Obama, but only marginally. He's much closer to President Obama in his temperament and who he is politically and in his political history than he is to the right. He doesn't fit really with Santorum and certainly doesn't fit with Ron Paul, and they all know it, and I think that's it. They know what's going on. They know he's not a right winger. He's not even a rightist. He's a man roughly of the center right, perhaps the way Obama is a man of the center left. They're not ready for him.
Chris, I think that the important thing to note here is that it's too early to call. We can't say that it's too close to call, but your point about how strongly Mitt Romney's...
That was my judgment based on history, not on any calculation on the part of our network.
I think, yes, and I think that it's right to be precise about that, but I think that your point is well taken about whether or not Mitt Romney can speak clearly and with a strong voice about where he stands among Republican voters after tonight. And I think a lot of people think that Mitt Romney, that he has no risk tonight, but I think that if some people start to look like they might think that other candidates are either worth considering looking at, even if they are not viable, or that somebody else might be viable if enough of them can coalesce around them, it does say something important about Mitt Romney. So we'll be watching this closely. At this point, too early to call, right. But thank you, Chris. With the caucuses underway across Iowa, let's get a look inside one of the big caucus sites. NBC's Ron Mott is northeast of Des Moines in Johnston, Iowa. He's at the Summit Middle School. We saw Rick Santorum speaking earlier. Ron, what's going on there?
Hey there. Well, they have not called this caucus to order officially. Let me step out of the way and show you what's happening here right now. Kentucky Senator Rand Paul is making one final pitch for his father, Congressman Ron Paul. Already tonight, before this caucus is officially open, we have heard from Rick Santorum himself trying to get those undecideds that are sitting in these chairs behind me to poll for him when they open the polling part of this discussion. J.C. Watts, the former Oklahoma congressman and Oklahoma Sooners quarterback, is at the back of the room. Anita Perry is here. She's expected to come and stump for her husband as they try to close the deal after a long, long time, a lot of footwork on the ground here. One of the things that Rick Santorum said to this crowd was that he learned very quickly when he got to Iowa that you cannot buy Iowa. He says they like to meet their candidates. They want to shake their hands personally. He went around the room and shook a lot of hands. So we are expecting to hear a lot of applause lines here as we go forward tonight. We are still not officially open, but once we get open, they'll make some formal pitches again to this crowd. Then all those blank sheets of paper will go out to those folks behind me. They'll sign the name of the person they are supporting, and then they'll start counting the votes. Rachel?
Ron, let me just ask you, if you are seeing visible signs of real organized support there in Johnston, are there people who are wearing a lot of campaign regalia who are trying to make it be known that that this is a place that should be seen as leaning toward their candidate, or is this pretty low-key?
I think it's pretty low key. I've said, but there are some campaign signs that you might see around the room. So some of the campaign workers were here before this all got started putting the signs up. I get the sense that some of the crowd here clearly in support of one candidate or another, but there seem to be a lot of folks whose body language would suggest that they were open to hearing the messages coming from these surrogates or the candidates themselves, as you see going on behind me. A lot of folks like to keep their options open. That's what we've been reporting all weekend long. A huge number coming into the weekend undecided. said, 41% of voters in that latest Des Moines Register poll. So a lot of folks wanted to hear these folks make one final pitch to earn their support tonight. And at the end of the night, they're hoping that their candidate is the one at the leader who is the leader of the pack. Rachel?
Ron Mott, thank you very much. Really appreciate that, Ron. Now, where Ron is in Johnston, Iowa. It's not that far outside of Des Moines. Des Moines is the largest city in Iowa, but it